watching Kenosha Community Television.
For music to survive in our community, it takes the entire community working together. So KSL gives a special thanks to Snap-on and its associates for caring about the KSO and caring about our community. My pleasure to introduce Terry Ruck, the manager of Snap-on's charitable giving, to share a few words with you. Thank you. You know, the Kenosha Symphony Orchestra has an outstanding concert planned today, and it's really going to put us in the holiday spirit. And I think just hearing the Lakeshore Philharmonic has already gotten us there, so what a great treat we had. Snap-on is proud to be the sponsor of this concert and a longtime partner of the Kenosha Symphony Orchestra over their inspiring 77-year history. Snap-on is a great company. Kenosha is our home. And music is essential. And our youth, they're our future. So we are extremely fortunate to have the Kenosha Symphony Orchestra in our community. And in the spirit of giving, if you decide today to put the giving tree, I'm very pleased to say that Snap-on will match dollar for dollar your gift today for a total collection of $5,000. So from the Snap-on family of associates and retirees, we wish you and yours a great holiday season and an even better new year. So enjoy the concert.
Thank you. Welcome, welcome to our holiday concert with the Kenosha Symphony Orchestra. Who's ready to hear some holiday music? Who's ready? I'm Dr. Aystein. I'm here to guide you through some great music this afternoon. So glad to see so many of you here, but I'm especially glad to see kids here today. So kids, you're in the right place. We're gonna make this a really wonderful day, get you into the holiday spirit today. So, whenever I plan this program, I do pick every piece that's on here, and I pick the right order, and I wanna explain a little bit of what I do. So, as music director of the Kenosha Symphony Orchestra, I'm your music director too. So I want you to hear some pieces that maybe you haven't heard before during the holiday season. Now, the first piece is called Shepherd's Hay. It's by Percy Grainger. Percy Grainger is a British composer, and Shepherd's Hay really doesn't have much to do with the holidays except for the fact that we have shepherds on the holidays and there's shepherds in the title. But I thought it was a great way to open this concert. And a lot of you people think of, hey, you know, in America, we say, hey, you know, it's an exclamation, but hey is a dance step, of a Morris dance, okay? And the composer heard this, and saw these Morris dances, and he decided to write this tune that had already existed, and write it for band, and write it for orchestra, write it for small ensemble, and he dedicated it to another important composer who wrote for his country about dances and folk music, Edvard Grieg. But let's go back even further. But by the way, remember shepherds, because shepherds come back at the end, right before intermission. So that's another thing. So shepherds are gonna tie this all together in the first half. The next piece, we need to go back even further. It says in your program, it says Christmas Concerto. Now, it's really important for you to understand why it's called a concerto. This is called a concerto grosso. What a concerto grosso is, it was written during the Baroque period. Important composers who wrote this would be Corelli. As a matter of fact, we did Corelli's Concerto Grosso a couple years ago, but this one's called a concerto, a Christmas concerto. So why is that? Well, it's really important for us to understand that there's a specific kind of music that has three subdivisions where we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which typically invokes what's called a pastorale, which means it has to do with Christmas music. Whenever they put in a pastorale, then it became something associated with Christmas. But we need to go all the way back. We need to go back to the time that this was written. And so I actually wrote down the notes when this was written. This was actually written during the 1700s. And it's important just for all of us to know that this was written in Bologna. And Torelli was credited with developing the Concerto Grosso. So let's go back to early music and listen to some Christmas music of that time.
Thank you.
Grosso that it really means big concerto. And one of the reasons why it's called a big concerto is because it features several solo instruments. So I had three of them stand up, which is instead of just one person playing a concerto, we have several, which is why they call it a concerto grosso. Now, as I talk about, as I pick all the music, as you've been coming to Kenosha Symphony concerts over the years, you know that for the holiday concerts, I like to throw at you some classical stuff in the first half, and then you get your dessert after intermission, okay? You get all those holiday favorites, and we're even gonna make you stand up and sing, okay? But we're gonna just delay that for a little bit as I try to escort you through this important music of the holidays. So now we're gonna get into, if you look at your program, the next three pieces all have the same title in them. It has what we all know as the word fantasia, although when I studied music, I remember my musicology professor said, we've been pronouncing that wrong all along, it's fantasia, okay? Because it's an Italian word, and so they, Italians don't really say j much. That's a French thing. So, but we've kind of adopted it. We all went and saw that Disney movie called Fantasia. But this one is fantasia, and what it is implied, and I want you to see if there's something that ties into from song to song to song that you're gonna hear. This first fantasia has to do with the fact that we're picking a particular melody and then we're going to kind of spin it and treat it around and kind of make a little variation upon it, maybe give it to a different instrument. And so we're gonna hear fantasia on Greensleeves. Now, Greensleeves is an important tune. Ralph Vaughan Williams, another British composer. Ralph Vaughan Williams, who we're gonna hear more than once today, he wrote this fantasia on Greensleeves. And then later in the 19th century, this was actually a very old tune called Greensleeves. And you're gonna hear, it's a 16th century folk song, and it's even mentioned by Shakespeare in his Merry Wives of Windsor play. He mentions it twice in there. So he wrote a few of these fantasias, Ralph Vaughan Williams did. So he took this old tune. Later on in the 19th century, somebody gave it new lyrics called What Child Is This? So the tune that we know as What Child Is This is actually an older song called Greensleeves. But you're also gonna hear another melody in here, okay? He throws in another melody called Lovely Joan, which is another old melody. He throws that in there as well. So the first fantasia that you're gonna hear is by Ralph Vaughan Williams, Greensleeves.
Thank you.
that was Fantasia number one, or Fantasia number one, we can call it that. So this next one, oh, by the way, what's really interesting about that one is, again, that piece could be performed, it was never intended to be a holiday piece, but we associate it with the holidays. And so there's a lot of music that we're going to do today when it was written. We somehow, over time, associated that with the holidays, and that is one of them. But this next one is in your face. It is about the holidays. It's Fantasia, or it's written by an American composer, so we're going to call it Fantasia. Okay, Fantasia on We Three Kings. So this, what's interesting about this particular one is that it also has What Child Is This? So I want you to listen. You're going to hear a treatment of We Three Kings, and there's no form to it at all. It's very improvisational in nature, okay? It's like the composer is going, I think I'll go this way instead of that way. And so that's what's happened with this one. We Three Kings, you already know it, but you're also, I want you to, with your ears, find What Child Is This? It's kind of like a word search puzzle for you.
Thank you.
introduce something that you probably never heard, and that was something I hadn't heard yet this year. And when I picked that music, I go, this audience is going to love a new treatment of that. So this next piece involves some help. And so hopefully, oh, they are. They're coming out on stage. Isn't that amazing? They knew before I needed them to come out on stage. When I first came here a few years ago to the Kenosha Symphony, I found right away that some of my most important friends were the fellow musicians in this community. And that is when I invited to participate in a lot of these concerts the Kenosha Chamber Choir. So please welcome to the stage the Kenosha Chamber Choir, who's going to be joining us. This next one is a Fantasia, or Fantasia. This one is about Christmas because it's called Fantasia on Christmas Carols. So this one, again, is by Ralph Vaughan Williams, the same composer who wrote the music on Greensleeves. This one has three different songs in it that are intentionally about the Christmas holiday. The first one is called The Truth Sent from Above. The second one is Come All You Worthy Gentlemen. It's going to seem a lot of these songs, you can see where we got our version when you hear these songs. And then the other one is called On Christmas Night, All Christians Sing. You're also going to hear a fourth one. Again, I'm going to give that to you as an assignment. You're going to hear the orchestra. Some members of the orchestra play the first Noel. You're not going to hear it sung, but you're going to hear it played by certain members of the orchestra. So I'm so glad that the Kenosha Chamber Choir is here, and I also want to introduce to you their new director. His name is John Krill. Would you please wave your hand? Thank you so much. Rehearsed them on this music more than I rehearsed them on this music, and they've got a ton of other music that they are rehearsing as well. So I'm just glad that they made time in their important holiday season of singing to come and join us on this concert. And we do love to involve them as much as possible. But there is one more helper, because we found out that there is a really important solo in it. And after a while, John just said, you know what, I think it would be important that we invite somebody else to sing this. And he said, would it be okay if Greg Berg sings this? And then I said, okay. But let me tell you, I'm kidding right now, but Greg Berg was one of the first friends I made coming here. He called me as the voice of the morning show. How many of you listen to the morning show on NPR, local NPR, yes? So you listen to him, and then I showed up, I joked about this last year, then I showed up to rehearse Beethoven's 9, and he's there playing piano. And then I go to a high school, and I'm rehearsing a Copland piece, and there he is playing piano as well. And I just realized, this guy is everywhere I go in Kenosha. And I joked last year that, you know what, I bet if my car broke down, and I took it to a garage, he would come out ready to change my oil. Okay? By the way, Greg, in about an hour, that's when I'm leaving. So if the oil can be changed by then, that would be awesome. Okay? But I'm so grateful because this is the first time I get to work with him when he sings. And it's really important to, he's on the voice faculty at Carthage College. He helps direct the opera program. He's the principal accompanist. Like I said, he is the voice of the morning show, WGTD, the local NPR, and he's a minister of music at Holy Communion Lutheran Church. And he's going to sing this incredible music by Ralph Vaughan Williams. Would you please welcome to the stage Greg Berg.
Thank you.
also want to ask you, when you go on Amazon, I know I do, everything is on Amazon, I'm a Prime member, I'm not advertising for them at all, but you know, they have Smile Amazon. You can actually put down Kenosha Symphony and we get a portion of all of your purchases. I know I'm going to be doing that because all my family lives out in California and I can have it wrapped and sent there. Again, Amazon should hire me to do their advertising. So set up an account, select Kenosha Symphony Association as your charity, then start shopping, we get a percentage. Thank you so much. Now the final one, it's pretty rare that we get a Christmas carol that's written recently. And this particular carol is written by another British composer. Yes, we've been doing a lot of British composers today. This one is by John Rutter, or as they say in the UK, John Rutter. They just pronounce everything out there, John Rutter. So this one, he wrote when he was very young. He wrote when he was 18 years old. So those of you who are young people, in a couple of years, you could write something like this. But it's so nice to hear a new Christmas carol. This one is called the Shepherd's Pipe Carol, and it celebrates the piping of a shepherd boy. Remember those shepherds? This is going to tie it all together. And on his way to Bethlehem. So let's listen to this final carol before we take our intermission.
Thank you.
first half. Now we get to play some of what we call the Pops music of the holidays. And that one was a collection of songs that you already know. This next one, coming from the Be Careful What You Wish For department, is called Winter Wonderland, which I hear we're gonna get after this concert. So, but I had nothing to do with it, okay? But we already know this, but it's really important. Just like there were songs in the first half that were written without any intention of it being about the holidays, believe it or not, this was not intended to be about the holidays. This winter, when it was about winter, there's hardly anything about Christmas or about any kind of holiday in this one. It was written about winter, not about Christmas. And it was written in 1934. Felix Bernard wrote the music. Richard B. Smith wrote the lyrics. And my only question is, what's this thing about Parson Brown? I don't know. Okay, I'm curious what they meant by that, because in the next verse, he's called a circus clown. So I'm not sure about that. Maybe somebody can tell me about that one after the concert. Winter Wonderland. Teufel, who wrote this Skater's Waltz. inspired by a skater's rink at the Bois de Boulogne in Paris. And when he saw this skating rink, which we have many of them now, he was inspired to write this waltz in 1882.
Thank you.
based on that poem, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas," and you remember that. Okay, we have a lot of people in there, and there's some people in this generation who may not know it, but what you're gonna hear right now, the Kenosha Chamber Choir is coming back on stage to put this poem to music. And it was one that I remember growing up with as well. So I want you to listen to the words carefully, because they are the exact same words that you probably read. I remember having somebody, a place of honor during the holidays, got to read this, and a family that I stayed with at one point, and they allowed me to read it, and it just meant so much to me. But this is the setting to music. Please listen to the words as best as you can, because it's a wonderful treatment. "'Twas the Night Before Christmas."
Thank you.
right now, because it's your turn to sing, they're coming out here, okay? And then, yeah, see, they're coming now. Find, do you have some words in your program, do you not? Yeah? So let's find in the program, and maybe we can have, let's see, Andy, do we have house lights up? And what we're going to do is we're going to ask you all to stand up. But right now, I would like you to meet the new director of the Kenosha Chamber Choir. This is John Creel. Would you give him a round of applause? Thank you for coming. All right, so like I said, it is your turn now. I want to hear your voices. I'm going to hear them good and loud, the spirit of the season. Audience, would you all stand up? If you follow your friends in the Kenosha Chamber Choir, they will show you when to start singing. They're going to sing with you. And I want to hear nice, spirited singing from all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
households, the board of directors, I wish you the best holiday season.